You know what I did? I took out burger. I cut up cabbage, onions. I got everything ready to make like a burger cabbage dinner thing. Guess what we're eating? I got new inventory at the store today, and I went and put it in. And it took a lot longer than I thought it was going to, so bag it. Also, while I was there, I realized I don't know what printout I was looking at, but I did not order enough yarn. My colors are not full. Some of them only have one now on the shelf. Ugh. This retail business is difficult. But I'm getting there. 19 Crimes, The Uprising. This is just a red. Doesn't even specify which red. I have watched this label before. It's really cool. This is an Irishman. I don't even know. I even looked him up. But I have no idea what his crime was. But apparently there's a pretty good story behind him falling in love with the main guard's daughter. Or the warden. What's it called? The head guy. Oh my goodness. I have no idea. But the problem is, I cannot get my Living Wine Labels app to work. I was going to try and record it so I could show you guys, because I don't even know his name. I cannot read the label. It's like, not a clue. I have to look him up again somehow, some way, and see what he's up to. What he was up to. Anyway. Open this up and see what it tastes like. Actually, I just pulled out the cork. And I don't know if maybe this is his crime. It says grand larceny, theft above the value of 1 shilling. So anything above 1 shilling counted. Well, yeah. So my guess is maybe that was his crime. Oh, crap. Ooh, it's strong. Ooh, it's strong. You guys know I'm not the biggest fan of red. Maybe I should stop smelling it and just drink it. It doesn't stick around long. It doesn't linger. It doesn't make me breathe fire. Those are all pluses in my book. Pretty good, actually. Not bad, not bad. Let's go talk about what I'm working on.
Is that delicious, sis?
What?
Is that your thing of popcorn?
Boys are watching. All in a huddle. It's hilarious. What movie is that? I'm working on this fun project. Cute little note from one of my favorite students, Dovey Grace. She knows I love mermaids. She drew me as a mermaid because my hair is pink. Also, taking a little bit of inspiration from this chick, the Inspired Wren, and making my crochet along for this year. I should say this upcoming year. So, my Knit Picks yarn, it's like a burgundy red. In fact, it's called, well, it's called Fairy Tale. It's just beautiful in real life. It's like a reddish purple. Hey, it's same color as my wine. Which you can't tell because it's in a blue cup. Anyway, Got my trusty foot dog here. He loves to be at my feet. So these are the squares that I've completed so far. The whole, I guess, gist of the project is going to be making 20 9-inch squares. Now, you could probably make as many as you want. I'm doing 20, and it ends up being 4x5. So, 9, 18, 36 inches wide, obviously. 36 and another 18, 5, oh, all right, 36 and another 9. So 45 inches, so not quite 4 feet. It's not a very big afghan, but it's a good lap size afghan. So what you do is over the course of 10 months is you're going to make 20 different squares. Yeah, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all the way to 10 here, and then another 10. So on month one, you'll make these two blocks, and then these two, and then these two, and yada, yada. I'm going to do it a little differently, and I'm going to make 20 different squares. I know, I'm a high achiever. So, using some of the ones that she had, this is just a simple zigzag, which is oftentimes how I do a lot of the brims on my hats. So it wasn't, too difficult to do that square. This one is a basket weave. It's kind of hard to see with the black, but it is gorgeous. That one I did in asphalt. And then this one is called the baby bobbles, and it is kind of like a little puff stitch, and they're worked at different angles. See this row, they're all worked like this, and then this next row, they're all worked like this. So that one was really fun. It worked up very fast. This one that I'm working on right now, square number 4, is shells. I don't know if you can see it. A shell of 5, and then a single crochet, and then another shell. I think in hers she called it a fan stitch, but I've always seen it called shell stitch, so that's what I'm gonna call it. And then in between each shell is another shell in the next row, and then so on and so forth. So you can see that there's quite a few in there, and I'm almost done right here. About this much left to do. So then all of these will have a border of about the same amount of stitches. I'm working with an H hook on most of these, which is pretty average hook size and works really well with this worsted weight yarn from Knit Picks that I sell at the store. So the thing about this crochet along project is that you're going to be able to work or to purchase the entire kit ahead of time. So by January, I should be able to have the entire afghan completed so everybody can see it, and also it all written up so that I can kind of get an idea of how many kits I need to order. I think it's going to take 14 skeins of the Knit Picks yarn and then the patterns and such. So now this is a rough estimate. Don't quote me on these prices, but my guess is it's going to be about $15 per month to get the yarn and the pattern and the instruction. It's just going to be one weekend. We're going to come one day that month and get the instruction. I might split it up that it's 2 days since I'm doing two different squares a month, whereas the original inspiration project was the same square. You just made two of them every month. We'll see how ambitious I get. So you can either pay as you go, $15 a month, or you can pay all ahead of time at once, and it's going to end up being, I think it'll end up being $150 for a break, because what it'll end up being is $180 if you pay every month, 12 months, yeah. So the first 10 months we make the squares. Month 11, we stitch it all together, and then month 12, we work on the border, and you should be done in time for Christmas project or Christmas presents, so you can gift it away or keep it, because that's a lot of work. Anyway, so that, I think, is going to be all for tonight. If I get that label working, I'll post it. I don't know what is going on with that app, but Since I'm not the only one, I'm not as worried. But hey, thanks for tuning in, and we will see you next time.